Time for a midnight snack. Ooh, but I gotta be quiet. Don't want to wake anyone up. Ow. Never mind. So much for being quiet. Imagine if walking around at night was always this hard. Thankfully, we have the option of turning on the lights, but in the wild, animals don't have the luxury of flipping a switch to see in the dark. Instead, animals that come out at night have some amazing adaptations to help them see and get around. Like cats, their eyes are adapted to see in extremely low light conditions. Or bats, they use sonar to locate their prey in the dark. Let's explore how animals have adapted to their environments, making their lives a whole lot easier than my midnight snack adventure. By the end of today's lesson, you'll be able to identify animal adaptations and describe how they help animals to survive in their environments. Let's get into it. In our last lesson, we learned that plants have adaptations that help them to survive and thrive within their environments. And plants aren't the only one. Animals also have adaptations, or specialized body parts or behaviors, that provide a particular benefit. See if you can spot some adaptations for yourself. Take a look at these penguins. Can you see anything that might help them to survive in Antarctica better than, say, a human? Maybe you saw their wide flippers, which help them to swim really fast. Or maybe you noticed their smooth, tightly packed feathers, which are waterproof and provide insulation from the cold. Perhaps you noticed their light bellies and dark backs. How do you think these colors might help penguins survive in their environment? Their white bellies allow them to blend in with the snow and ice they swim under, while their dark heads and backs allow them to blend in with the dark water on the horizon, providing two layers of protection from predators. Almost every unique feature of these penguins provides some benefit to their survival in this harsh Antarctic climate. Many adaptations, like we saw with the penguins, help animals to live within their specific climate conditions. In hot desert climates, for instance, animals have adaptations to prevent them from overheating. For instance, the fennec fox's large ears help to disperse heat, keeping the fox cool in the Sahara Desert. And they're stinking adorable. These climates often have very little rainfall, making water hard to come by. No worries for the kangaroo rat, though. It barely needs to drink. It gets its water from the seeds it eats, and it has kidneys that conserve water extremely well. What animals can you think of that live in a desert? What adaptations do they have to help them to survive there? Pause the video and record your thoughts in your guided notes. Adaptations that help animals to survive in their climate aren't limited to body parts, though. Many adaptations are actually behavior. Can you think of any animals that change their behavior depending on the time of year, for instance? There are many examples of this, but one very visible example is migration, or the seasonal movement of animals from one region to another. Canadian geese, for example, spend most of the year in Canada and the northern United States. When winter rolls around, though, they fly south to access more abundant food and avoid those harsh winters. Other behavioral adaptations are less visible, though. Groundhogs, for instance, go into hibernation in the winter months, slowing their metabolism to conserve energy while food is harder to find. Besides adapting to their climate conditions, animals also have adaptations that help them to get food. Consider the giraffe. What adaptation does a giraffe have to help it obtain food? Exactly! Its long neck allows it to reach leaves high up in trees that other animals can't get to, giving it a significant advantage in the savannas of Africa. What about when an animal's food source is a bit faster than leaves on a tree? Animals that rely on hunting for their food have adaptations to help them track down their prey. The cheetah is a perfect example, with its incredible running speed of up to 65 miles per hour. Remind me to never get into a race with one of them. Some hunters also have the adaptation of extremely keen eyesight, like the eagle, which can spot its prey from up to 2 miles away. Think about some of the other great hunters of the animal kingdom, like the great white shark with its large fins. How do you think this adaptation is helpful as they hunt? Record your thoughts in your guided notes. The adaptations we've discussed so far are amazing and impressive, but they're not very helpful if those animals just immediately get eaten. Which is why many adaptations in the animal kingdom come down to evading predators. Ever play hide and seek? Well, hiding in plain sight is an extremely common adaptation for many animals. Camouflage is when an animal blends in with their surroundings. A few animals can actually change their body color in order to camouflage, like the mimic octopus, which can change color to blend in with the background, or even imitate other marine life. Most animals that use camouflage, however, have only one appearance that blends in with their typical surrounding. For example, can you see the animals in these pictures? Did you spot them? Camouflage can greatly reduce the chance of an animal becoming lunch. Now, I hear what you're saying. Justin, if camouflage is such a great adaptation, then why are there so many brightly colored animals? Well, camouflage is a great strategy for avoiding predators, but it's not the only one. In fact, some animals have adapted to have bright, noticeable colors as a warning to keep predators away. Many poisonous or venomous animals are brightly colored to tell predators, hey, don't eat me, I am not a tasty snack. The colors of animals like the poison dart frog, the lionfish, and the monarch butterfly may be beautiful, but they're basically flashing warning signs to any potential predators. These bright colors are so effective at keeping predators at bay that some other animals have adapted to have similar colors, even though they don't pose the same danger the colors are meant to warn of. This adaptation is called mimicry. The coral snake, one of the most venomous snakes in North America, has a pattern of red, yellow, and black rings along its body. The scarlet king snake, on the other hand, is completely non-venomous, but it shares an extremely similar color pattern. These mimic animals piggyback off the hard work of animals that are actually dangerous. Pretty solid strategy, if you ask me. Let's review everything we've learned today. An adaptation is a specialized body part or behavior that benefits an organism in its environment. Adaptations can help an animal to endure climate conditions, access food, avoid predators, and so much more.
To learn more about animal adaptations, be sure to check out the activities and practice questions that go with this lesson. Wow. What amazing adaptations. Just like my little adventure trying to get a snack in the dark showed us, navigating the world can be quite the challenge without the right tools and adaptations. Let's be inspired by these incredible animals and embrace our own ability to adapt and learn, facing life's challenges with curiosity. Because remember, scientists, curiosity is the architect of discovery. See you next time! Hey, hey.